Hello everyone, and welcome to this episode in which we look back to our sailing adventures in 2014. Our sailing season started a little bit later than we anticipated, but in August we finally got a chance to go on a trip. In episode 1 you can see how we sailed through Amsterdam via the Standing Mast route, but this time we went the other way. There's another option. We sailed through the Ring Canal around the Haarlemmermeer polder during the day. We had a stopover after we crossed all the bridges and the lock in Haarlem, and then continued via the North Sea Canal to the Markermeer. This episode begins with us leaving our home port, Aalsmeer, to go to the Markermeer. Hello everyone, we are Rob and Jouke, and this is our cat Tijger. While we both still have jobs, we try to sail as much as we can on our boat Sirius. Please join us as we sail the beautiful waters of the Netherlands. Next morning, we went through the bridge onto the North Sea Canal to go to the Markermeer. It was a sailing trip with a lot of wind, and we were happy that we had finally arrived in Den Oever. We took a walk to stretch our legs and enjoyed the beautiful sight of the Waddenzee. The Waddenzee is an intertidal zone in the southeastern part of the North Sea. It lies between the coast of the northwestern continental Europe and a range of low-lying Frisian islands, forming a shallow body of water with tidal flats and wetlands. The island Texel is 177 square kilometers. That is roughly the size of Washington DC. It is the most populated island of the West Frisian Islands in the Waddenzee. After we docked Sirius, we went for a trip around the island of Texel in this little car. We had a lot of fun exploring the island like this. Back at the boat, we enjoyed a meal with fresh seafood we got in Den Oever. On our way from Texel to the IJsselmeer, we took a different route. We wanted to explore the other side of the IJsselmeer, and so we went towards the lock in Kornwerderzand and wanted to spend the night in Makkum. The weather was pretty nice. The only downside was that there was no wind and we had to motor across the Waddenzee. When we got ready to leave Makkum the next morning, we noticed a group of rabbits having breakfast opposite to our boat. The next leg of our trip was to go south to the dike that separates the IJsselmeer from the Markermeer, and then go through the lock at Lelystad and cross the Markermeer to go to Markum. When approaching Marken, we sailed on a beam reach and we were practically flying across the Gouwzee. In the 13th century, Marken was separated from the mainland during a storm. A period of centuries of isolation followed for the inhabitants, who lived from fishing. Marken was only connected to the mainland by a dike in 1957 and has been a peninsula ever since. Until the 17th century, residents built their houses on mounds, which they called yards. This was a flood protection. Later, the residents started building houses on stilts. Since the construction of the Afsluitdijk, the island no longer has to deal with flooding, but the typical houses have remained. The Afsluitdijk is a fundamental part of the larger Zuiderzeeworks, damming off the Zuiderzee, a saltwater inlet of the North Sea, and turning it into the freshwater lake, the IJsselmeer. The dam serves as a sea barrier to protect the inland against flooding. We picked up some groceries and our friend Erik, who is sailing with us to Haarlem. Nothing ever felt as good or as easy as when we were young. Though I felt misunderstood, it was a pleasure running away with you. We were just children acting like a dog. Usually I hoist the sails, but now that we had Erik on board, he could do the hoisting. We were
it didn't fall apart harder than we did. Now they keep us on speaking terms. We grow and we learn. I have no regrets, only forgets. Oh, a big thank you to life for giving us end. Oh, when the timing's right, there's no wasteland. Oh, we were just children acting like adults.
We sailed past Pampas, and because we had some time to spare, we paid this small island a visit. Pampas is part of the old defense line of Amsterdam, the Stelling van Amsterdam. This defense line was located in a large circle around the center of Amsterdam. The defense line contains 45 forts and was constructed from 1880 to 1920. Part of the defense line is Fort Island Pampas in the former Zuiderzee. After this short coffee break, we sail to Haarlem without further interruptions. Thanks for watching, everyone. If you like what you saw, please give us a thumbs up and leave a comment to let us know what you think. This is highly appreciated. More information and links about the topics in this episode can be found beneath this video. We try to upload new episodes weekly. If you subscribe to this channel, you get a notification when a new video is out. See you next time. Bye!